Hello, pool fans everywhere. I'm Grady Matthews in the booth with my good friend who happens to be the number one nine ball player in the world, Johnny Archer. And Johnny, we're going to do a player review in a match that you played yesterday. Why don't you describe your opponent? He's kind of an emotional player, isn't he?
Well, Morro, Ismael PAEZ, is a great player to watch. He's a lot of fun to watch because he's very animated. You know, he has a lot of body expressions and hand expressions and great player. And you know, he's very exciting to watch. So this is a good match we played here.
And you lost the lag, I see, and you're racking the balls up.
Lost the lag, and so I racked the balls. And this match kind of starts off a little funny, especially for me. But he makes the one ball there. And he hadn't got a real good shot on the two.
Well, it's hard for him to get on the three. That's up on the end rail, along with the four ball, and it looks like it's kind of hard for him to clear this six and eight ball, right?
Yeah, actually, he makes a good shot here. He's shooting at the two in the lower right-hand corner. He's trying to get up table in between the nine and five. Makes a two in between the nine and five. He actually goes a little bit far. Okay, now he's actually okay, but he went a little further than he would have liked. He'd like to bounce off a little bit more on the rail.
Well, this looks all right to me.
Yeah, but he's having to shoot the four. Now across back in the other
across the short,
on the
rail.
Short side, yeah.
Well, let's mention to anybody that may just be watching a U.S. Open 1997 tape for the first time, these pockets are extra tough, aren't they?
They are. They're playing real good. The table's kind of slow, which makes the game harder because, you know, you have to hit the balls a little harder, so it makes them a little bit tougher to make. But Morro executed a very good shot there.
And he's got a nice angle to get on the six ball.
Nice angle on the six.
Now he wants to be careful not to get where he has to hit the eight ball when he makes the six, otherwise the seven might be difficult to get on.
Yeah, exactly right. He wants to kind of stay just a little bit past the nine, not a lot, but hits it pretty good. Looks like he almost fell down, but
you know, well, that's kind of his style anyway, yeah.
He shot it and he looked like he almost fell flat of his face, but you know, he executed a good shot.
Yeah, he can do about anything he wants. He'll probably just come down one rail here.
Yeah, I think that's what he does. Goes down one rail to about where he's at now.
Good shot.
Okay, and now it's like tic-tac-toe from here. It's kind of all just preliminary shooting.
I want to ask you a question because I'm always interested in improving my game in these major tournaments, and breaking from the box is relatively new to me, and you're, you know, kind of renowned for having one of the better breaks in the world. Do you make a big adjustment to break from the box, or do you break the same way, maybe with a little bit less velocity?
Actually, it's a little bit harder to control your cue ball from the box. To me, it is, because it seems like the cue ball hops a little more, and it's kind of weird because you wouldn't think it would hop more because shooting off the rail, you're hitting more down at it. But to me, the cue ball hops a little bit more to me.
Do you play it to stop in the middle of the table, or you try to go to a rail?
I try to control it in between the sides. I try to just keep it to where you don't get to a rail. And if you do, you don't want to hit it with much speed. So, I just try to, you know, keep that.
Okay. Well, at any rate, you have not had a chance to step to the table with any kind of shot yet, and it's 1-0 advantage Morro.
1-0 Morro, and he's breaking here. Okay, he didn't hit that break too good, but
he made
a couple balls, which
I can't tell which one is a two ball or did
he
make
down.
It? Is that down at the other end of the table there? Is that
two's one? Down in the box, the only ball inside the box there, as you can see. Well, that was a four. Okay.
Okay,
well,
this is a three
mistake.
And four at the other end of the
our
table.
Mistake.
Well, really, Johnny, all he's got to do is get on this four ball, and this should be a pretty easy racket.
Yeah, it should be. Just come off the rail, get over to the left side there. Well, okay, I remember that now. God, how can I forget that? Okay, and well, that's my first opportunity. I don't know if he shot that ball the right way.
No, I liked your way of playing it.
You can hit a little more harder, and the accuracy is a little easier when you hit the balls a little bit harder.
Sure, and you have that whole one quarter of the table to the left of the four where you can be fine. Even if you get straight in, you're okay.
Exactly, because the five's down by the six, and And well, this was my first opportunity, and I knew I, you know, I was very nervous this match. I can remember this.
That's kind of unusual for you, too. You're not usually nervous, right?
Well, I get nervous, but it's never really that bad. It's always kind of a good nervous. But I remember this match. I was very nervous, and I hadn't been playing that well of late. And Morro being my second match, you know, of the tournament, you know, it's kind of a tough draw, and you know, you want to play good in the U.S. Open, which I always do. You know, U.S. Open's always a tough one for me, but...
Well, especially this year because of the conditions. Tough pockets. It's a little humid in here.
Yes, they are.
And they're keeping it cold, too. Have you been cold?
I was cold today. I played a match earlier, and I was... But this was kind of a... This kind of was an easy rack, good rack for me to start with. You know, everything kind of laid together. Them type of shots, sometimes I have to make sure I don't miss cue.
Sure,
short draw shots.
I've noticed a lot of miss cue in here.
It's because the tables are kind of damp, and, you know, the chalk is getting a little bit wet, and it's kind of just coming off the cue.
All right, the score is one each, and this is our first opportunity to watch you break the balls. How many times would you say you've played Morro in the past?
I probably played Morro 5 times, I would have to guess.
Do you know what the past record is?
I've got a pretty good record, I think. I would have to guess maybe 4-1, maybe something like that. I would think so. But Morro's always a tough player because he's very gritty, and he just plays pretty smart, you know, and he makes... You know, just makes all his shots, you know.
Sure.
He just
a little bit unorthodox style.
Right. Yeah, I remember that. I jumped
the
table.
Oh, now you jumped the table.
I jumped the table, which is very, very uncharacteristic. I usually control that pretty good. I don't jump the table. I may scratch or something, but I usually don't jump the table. So that wasn't a good way to start as far as breaking the balls. I was very, I wasn't happy with that.
Well, it looks like the 2-ball on the end rail.
Yeah, maybe I think it's the 1.
And the 3 by the left-hand side pocket?
No, I think it's I think that's the 3 there, and the 4 again.
Oh, okay.
It's hard for us to get that color.
Some of those
we're
are
getting
hard
the 2
to
and
see.
The 4 kind of mixed up. But this is, he got himself kind of tricky here. He had to, he's shooting this ball in the corner, and he wanted to shoot in the side, but he made a good shot. But it was kind of a tricky shot. He didn't want to really get there, I don't think.
Now he'll just come up and play the 5 in the side pocket here.
Yeah, he's just going to come up one rail in between the 5 and the 9 there. You know, he'll touch one rail and come up, shoot the 5 in the side. Okay, everything. He came up a little further than he wanted.
Well, this is all right. All he's got to do is make the ball.
Yeah. Actually, it's kind of a type of shot where you just want to make sure you make it.
Low left.
Yep. He hit it good. He comes up nice. Actually, a little tricky again. Now he shoots this shot. He's shooting the 6 in the side, and he comes straight down table, and he's going to pocket the 7. He's going to try to shoot the 7 right up where he's at now, into that pocket, which is kind of a different way, but it's a pretty safe shot. I kind of like the shot he shot, you know, because I probably would have done that. Now he just comes straight off the rail, and it's kind of the angle was there to go in at the 7, so it's...
Well, as you look at it, it's hard to fault that way of playing it.
Right. And a lot of people might have tried to come up and do more with it, whereas, you know, that shot was actually a pretty simple shot. That's where a lot of people sometimes, a lot of players try to do, you know, more with the ball than they have to.
That's one of the big keys, too, isn't it, Johnny? Keep it simple.
Yeah, that's all you have to do. You know, a lot of times if they see a ball near the side pocket or, you know, something like that, it seems like they always think, I've got to shoot position for the side since that's where it's at. And you don't have to. You know, I shoot position for a lot of corner pockets. I play a lot of bar table position a lot because, you know, just making sure you get where you can make the ball. You know, so a lot of times I play a lot of bar table position and on the big table. And sometimes my shots are, you know, maybe a little longer than a lot of guys. But what it is, you know, I just make sure I have a shot, you know.
Well, I hate to
snooker myself, you know.
And you're young and one of the great shot makers in the history of our great sport, and a little longer really doesn't affect you much. At any rate, it's 2-1 Paez.
2-1 Paez, and he's breaking.
I know you didn't like going off the table. That's almost like a gift there.
There's a 9 on the break.
Okay, 3-1.
Now that went 3-1.
Why is it, Johnny, that when you make it in a, you know, an inadvertent mistake like jumping the cue ball off the table, so often either they make the 9 on the break or break and run out on you. So
yeah,
it costs you double.
It happens so much. If you make a mental mistake or an easy mistake where you should have won the game or something, a lot of times it don't just cost you that game. It costs you
well,
2, 3, 4,
here.
Maybe 5 games.
Right, exactly.
So the next time you get to shoot, you know, you might be, instead of that one game down, you might be 5 more.
Look at this, the 9's going towards the pocket again. All right,
okay.
He doesn't make a ball on the
he
break.
He didn't make a ball there.
And you're at the table.
Okay, I actually kind of have a tough out here.
I'm interested to see, can you reach this by leaning your body over the table?
No, I can't. I have to use the bridge here. I remember this. I have to use the bridge. And this is kind of a tricky shot.
Well, sure, the 2-5. I mean, the 2 doesn't pass the 5, right?
No, that's exactly right. But the thing about it is, I like these shots because I can judge going off the rail real easy.
Do you like a ball first hit? I like ball first, not rail first here.
I go rail first all the time.
Oh, you do?
All the
time.
Well,
isn't that interesting?
Near about every, even if the ball's froze, a lot of times I try to go rail first, which, you know, if it's froze, a lot of times you don't. But I always try to go rail first because if I happen to spin it too much, then I catch the ball. And the pocket's kind of big, you know, if you go in rail first, and I make it, I mean, that's the way I shoot them shots, and I make it a lot
now,
of times.
Now, can you see this 2 ball?
I can. I can see this 2 here, and I have to shoot 2-5, which is kind of tricky because I got straighter on the 2 than I wanted.
In other words, you can't control the 2 ball.
Yeah, exactly. Well, the 2 ball is not doing much with the 5, but the cue ball is going straight toward the bottom rail and kind of up close to the 2. But I kind of hit it with a little bit of firm stroke to make the cue ball jerk off the rail a little bit. And it kind of went forward, and, you know, I ended up pretty good.
Yeah.
Now, I remember this shot was one that it kind of posed a little problem to me. I didn't know exactly how to shoot it because I didn't want to shoot the combination
right
on the 3-9 because I would have to get an off angle combination. But if I can get up for the 3 in the side, it would make it really easy. But the 7 posed a problem. And then going up in between them, I'm going toward the 3 too much. So I didn't really like that. So
and you can't go 2 rails, that other ball's in the way.
Exactly. So the shot I tried here, I shot it where I cut the 2 real thin and just went straight up to our right side of the 7 right now, kind of toward the 6. And toward the rail, and I got pretty good on it. You know, I kind of played it safe and just made sure I didn't, I made sure I got a shot on the 3. And if I'd have stayed on the rail over there, it would have been tough for me. But now this shot was another one that was kind of tricky to me. I couldn't follow it off the rail because I would kind of, cue ball would land like in the box. So what I done is, I'm trying to shoot the 3 in the side, and I'm kind of forcing it out 3 rails around to shoot the 4 in the
same
side.
Yeah, but, you know, these side pockets are small.
Yeah.
And you don't have near the opening. Like, if this were a big pocketed table, this would be an easy shot
right
to kind of punch
yeah,
it around.
Yeah, it wouldn't be
there.
That hard. And I remember I made sure that I stayed down on this ball because it was kind of a – I've hit the point a lot where it jerks it out.
Sure.
And I stayed down on it. Actually,
worth mentioning, I think, too, that you elevated the cue. You got to make sure you don't hit that 6 ball there.
Exactly. That's exactly right. Oh, I couldn't. I had to elevate and had to hit it kind of firm.
Sure.
But I felt pretty good, and now.
That was a nice shot, much harder than it looked. Now you can do about what you want here.
Yeah. Well, I'm laying. I remember this one. I was laying kind of funny, and I didn't. I couldn't come inside the 8. I didn't want to draw it out 2 rails because in case I don't hit it hard enough, I'm behind the 7. So what I done here. And I didn't want to just roll forward because I'd be real straight on the 6 or actually have the angle the other way where it'd be hard for the 7. So I try to jerk it back, try to hold the angle about 3-4 inches to where I can just draw it. I can just draw it straight out.
Did you end up straight in on this or you have a slight angle?
End up kind of straight in. So it was actually okay to where I knew the cue ball wasn't going to go straight up the rail. So it was actually okay because I knew the 7 wouldn't pass the 8 in case I went far. So. Yeah, actually, laid kind of where I wanted.
That's a good shot. now you're in pretty good shape. All you really have to do here is make the seven.
Yeah, this was just the shot, just make the seven, and then I have the 8-9. Yeah, I was very tentative in the first few games of this match. I played tentative. I was just making sure I was taking my time. I wasn't real comfortable all the way, so I wanted to make sure I took my time and made a simple out simple instead of just, trying to do something and then getting out of line or something and making it tough.
Well, our score is now 3-2, Paez. Well, I got to compliment you, Johnny, on one thing. I don't think I've ever said this to you, but I think your pace at the table is terrific. You don't allow your opponents to get you playing at their tempo. You play at your own speed, which is comfortable for you, and you're kind of unflustered, which is probably why you're the number one nine ball player in the world.
Well, and I used to be the opposite of that. I remember as I was coming up, if a guy played fast, a lot of time I noticed I got into his rhythm playing fast, or if he played slow, sometimes I started taking more time. And I jumped. My second time jumping. And about right then, I was. You could have fried an egg on my head about that time.
Anyway, to get back to what we were talking about, didn't you find that when you did that, the results were usually bad?
Very bad. I kind of noticed I got to play in the other guy's game, and it just wasn't. It wasn't good. It wasn't feasible. I didn't win. And so I had to change. And, it just come from playing tournaments, playing the top players, just getting more mature, learning, and just coming up with your own pace. Don't let things bother you because things are going to happen. I mean, you're going to see stuff to happen.
I don't think people realize just exactly how much you paid your dues. You paid them in every way.
Well, I was very lucky to be able to come along and to have tournaments to play in. To have great players like yourself. You were coming up. I mean, you were playing, very good when I was coming up. And I watched you. I watched Nick Varner. I watched Buddy Hall. Earl. I can just
What about our deceased friend? He was a big inspiration to you.
Our deceased friend is
a great guy.
Well, I can't begin to tell you how much he helped me. I just can't tell you that much. I mean, I'd be here and we wouldn't have enough time on the tape. But he was a very big friend of mine, a very good friend of mine.
And one of the great minds in pool.
Oh, very smart player. He was very aggressive. He knew how to take you down. When it came time to take you down, he could do it. And I learned a lot from that because a lot of players don't know how to do that. They get up and they get a guy beat, and then they start trying to play safe, or they start trying to protect their lead, or maybe they'll go for an extra shot that they wouldn't have. They get out of their game because of the score. That's one thing you cannot do, playing this game. You cannot let the score affect the way you play.
You're supposed to play the game exactly the same all the time,
You have to play as, I mean, now sometimes the way your opponent's playing or the way things are going, if things are just not going good for you, or something like that, sometimes you may shoot a shot you wouldn't or something like that, but you should never shoot a shot by what the score is. That's just not, what you have to do. You have to just go on with your game plan. You should have a game plan. It's the same thing in golf. Guys go out and they have a game plan. They know how to play the course. They know what club they're going to use off the tee.
Now, while we're talking about that, and he's going to go ahead of you 4-2 here.
He goes up 4-2.
One of the great disappointments for golf fans all over the world, including me, I've always liked Greg Norman, and when he collapsed at the Masters and blew that 6-stroke lead, mm-hmm. Did you notice that he played a completely different game on Sunday than he did Thursday, Friday, and Saturday?
He played very different. He was, he started playing the tournament. He started playing the score,
Oh, sure.
And he got out of his game. Nick Fowler never done anything different. The guy that came back and beat him, he never done anything different. He just hit the ball. He hit driver on every hole that he did the rest of the week or the first of the week, and he hit the same shots in. I mean, how can you have a 6-stroke lead and then all of a sudden think, well, I'm going to change my game now? I mean, that part, I remember what you're talking about.
Well, that's my point. You excel at not changing your game. It's the same all the time. Now, you remember what he does with this? He's ahead of you 4-2.
He's ahead of me 4-2 here. And I didn't know what he was going to do here. This was a difficult shot. And he tries to cut this ball in the corner. And successfully does it. And he hits the two and gets a shot.
Now, a lot of people might think that's lucky. I don't. He came down in the direction of the two.
Direction of the two.
Which, you know, sometimes you can make a little thicker or a little thinner hit on that object ball than you want, and it affects the exact direction of the cue ball. But I wouldn't say that he was lucky to get a shot on the two there.
Not at all. The thing about it is people think that you're lucky when you go into balls and get a shot. You're not. The thing about it is you have to just make sure you're going to have a shot when you go into it. You know, if he has to kiss it too thin, he's going to have a safety. You know, he could play a safety.
But he's going to be able to see the
two. He's going to be able to see the two and have an offensive shot. Even, I mean, people don't understand, a safety is an offensive shot just like anything. You're vying for a shot. You're vying to be able to have to run out.
Well, you're trying to do the best thing you can do to win the game.
Exactly. And, I mean, I think all nine ball is offense, whether you're playing safe or not. You know, I just think that's just a type of offense.
Oh, look.
Now, he missed a five here. And now this was my chance to come back here. It was 4-2. Things were kind of not going real well. He was playing well, and he made a mistake.
Well, this is a little touchy, though, too. Looks like you have got to go into the seven or completely lag the ball, which you don't want to do, right?
Actually, this shot here fooled me. It looked like I was going to miss the edge of the seven, okay, by just rolling it, okay, and putting a little bit of spin on. I thought I was going to miss the edge of the seven by rolling it, but I got fooled. I went into the seven here, okay, and it kind of fooled me, and you know, the shot was just a. Sometimes you see it and you think the ball's gonna go up, go a little more full into the you know, through the ball, but sometimes it don't.
So you're trying to miss the seven.
I tried to actually miss a seven. Now that there, I see, I hit the edge of the seven.
Now you've ended up tough here.
It made it kind of tough on me. Now this shot here was a weird shot because I was real close to the six and cutting it back the other way.
Well, it looks to me like if you use low right English, you can't get back far enough to get a good shot on the seven. Is that the problem you have?
Actually, no. What I done here is I tried to miss the 8-9.
Okay.
And hit the short rail on the side rail.
Okay.
And I actually hit it too low. And I hit it too low here, see? And I came out too sharp. Okay, I kind of caught the point of the corner, and it got tough on the seven. Now, this was just a make shot. You know, I make it, you know, the 8-9's there, so I just attempted to try to just roll it in here.
But let's talk about the toughness of these pockets once again. This is not nearly as easy a shot as it would be if the pockets were bigger.
Well, if the pocket's bigger, you know, you get it going anywhere close down the rail, it's going to go in.
Sure.
It'd be like a sewer down there. But that's why I was kind of trying to take my time and just make sure I hit a natural shot and make it. But now this shot here, I remember this. This was kind of a funny shot when I hit it. See the ball roll out?
I thought
the ball
you made
actually
it.
Roll. When I hit it, usually whenever I hit a shot and I think it's going in, usually it goes in. That shot I really thought I made when I hit it. And I was watching it right through. The ball did roll out a little bit. Maybe it caught a piece of chalk or something like that. But actually, I thought I made that ball, and it looked like it rolled out a little. So this is here's his opportunity to go up 5-2 on me.
And he's going to do that. There's a big difference here, too, 5-2 instead of 4-3, and you're breaking. Now, considering that you've missed one ball that you probably normally would make, and you've jumped off the table twice, the score probably about reflects that.
That's exactly right. That reflected a three-game score. You know, he's played well. He's actually missed a couple balls, and one of them I didn't take advantage of, and the other one I did. But, you know, and here, this was going to the point to where, as you could say, it's, you know, enough was enough. You know, I can't give him any more air from here. And
no, a couple of more mistakes and you're probably all done. A
couple more mistakes and you're exactly right. It would be all done.
Now, he doesn't make a ball on the break here, but you've got a hard shot. In fact, you can't bridge this comfortably. And as I view it, you're going to have a hard time getting on the two ball.
Yeah, I couldn't be offensive with this shot because of the three. If the three wasn't there, I could have made a good bridge with a little inside English and just make it go straight up table. But what I try to do here is I try safety here.
We try to go over behind the 5-7?
Behind the 5-7. Okay, and I actually hit it too hard. Okay, and left him. I didn't leave him a good shot here. Actually, the one stop, pretty good for me. But he tries to masse here. And he tries to masse and make the one.
That, and you mentioned how aggressive he is, and that's a good point because he's got a great safety.
Okay, he actually hit it pretty good. Okay, about this time I'm a little bit flustered. I'm really not happy. I made a mistake. I jumped the table a couple times. When I get to where I'm really not happy with myself is when I'm nervous and I know it and it bothers me.
Now, does this one go here, Johnny?
It does go in the corner.
Okay.
And I have to stay on the short side of the five. Okay, I hit that wide. Kind of got a pretty good safety out of it, but I remember I hit it wide.
Well, I don't know what he's going to do here. The safety I like is banking the one right back up about where the cue ball is.
That's exactly
there.
What he does.
Like
he hits
that.
It good. He hits a good shot here. Leaves me where I couldn't tell if I can get by the six, but even if I could have, all I could do was hit the one thin, and it just wasn't a real good shot.
Yeah, you're going to sell out a lot
I'm
more than
sell
you
out. You know, I couldn't even control the cue ball hitting the one so thin.
So what do you decide to do?
I decide just to go ahead and kick to the right rail. I mean, that's one thing about players. They think, well, if they can hit the ball, well, they have to shoot at it. You know, a lot of times, sometimes you just have no option.
Well, I think you made a wise decision. There's a lot of good things can happen by going to the right-hand far side rail. You might make that, the two ball up there by the one?
Two.
You might make that. You might get it safe.
Yeah, it was very, I didn't want to have to kick, but, you know, I knew at least more good things could happen this way than just hitting the side of the one. Okay, now, I actually see, I kind of got away with it.
Well, again, that's not really lucky there. You played it in such a way you got a great chance to get distance between the cue ball and the object ball.
Right. I just kind of hit the side of the one, and I knew the one wasn't going to really go a long ways, and the cue ball, I'm going to hit it hard enough to where the cue ball is going to do something.
He gets
unlucky, but then he gets kind of lucky because there's one dead stop there. And I remember.
But this is a lot easier.
A lot easier it would end up on the left side over. Oh, a lot easier. I was a lot more happy with this shot.
A lot of ways to play this. You're going to play to make a thicker hit, it a little?
I'm drawing a little bit, trying to just make sure the cue ball stays down there and the one, I'm trying to get it up table. Now, see, I try to get it by the one, by the nine, and it lays right on the nine.
Well, this looks like a pretty dead 1-9 combination.
It was definitely.
He's pretty good at combinations, too.
He is very good at combinations. And he just rolls it right on in.
Okay, it's 6-2.
Yeah, I'm down 6-2 here. And about this time, you could, I was kind of mad. But one good thing I done during this match is I remember, thinking to myself, all you have to do, breaking from the box, you just have to play the shots you get. You can't do it. You can't help what's already happened. There's nothing you can do about it. But you can help with what happens,
from
this point on. And
well, that's another compliment that I'm glad to pay you. You play very well. You retain your composure. If you get a little bit down, you don't get all ruffled and everything.
Well, the thing about it is, that's another thing. I've seen players sometimes when they get down, they change their rhythm then. They try to change their game plan. They maybe start playing a little faster, a little slower. That's one thing I've always been pretty good at, just keeping my game plan, whether the scores I'm ahead or down. Okay, I had a pretty good bank there, and I missed it, but I actually had a pretty good bank there. That wasn't really
hard.
Yeah,
it looked like it laid pretty straight ahead.
But I had to kind of spin it and hold the cue ball. And I'm usually pretty good at my banks. I usually bank the balls pretty good. But that one I did. And
Looked like you might have struck it maybe a shade easy.
I think that is what I did. A little harder, I think.
And you missed it a little on the long side, too.
Long side, yeah. That comes from hitting the ball a little easier most of the time.
Well, you're probably like I am. I would prefer to hit most of my banks at least a little crisply. You know, that doesn't mean blast them or anything.
No, that's exactly. Just hit them a little more firm, and it makes the ball, you know, banks, you know, you want to keep the ball as straight coming off the rail as anything.
Sure.
You know. But this shot here, he kind of had a shot. Okay, he hit it easy, and this is going to hit the L, and he's not going to get a rail here. And so that was very, very a lucky break for me. And, you know, it was a good chance for me to be able to come up and have
an easy combination.
Easy one, that's what something I really needed about that time.
Oh, sure.
Down 6-2 and going to 11.
I get so mad at myself, Johnny, when I make a mistake like that, because what he should have done is said to himself, well, if I make a little bit of a miss hit here, let's hit it a little too hard. And at least that way you get a rail.
Yeah, exactly right. I mean, anytime you're going toward balls, and you're trying to hold the cue on, you're going length of the table, a lot of times the ball, you know, it's not going to get the rail hard anyway if it does hit the rail.
You ever notice how every once in a while it's possible to even make a nice kick shot, and the one that you kick at hits a ball, and then it hits another one. In other words, you hit it plenty hard to get a rail.
You're exactly right. Okay, about this time, I was really concentrating on.
Now, let's see if you make an adjustment here.
I made sure I didn't scratch.
All right, good.
Jump the table. And I did take off of the break. I remember that.
Well, I didn't make anything. Off the table.
I didn't make anything, but I just wanted to make sure, you know, I didn't jump the table, and balls really wasn't scattering that well to start with. So.
No, everybody's been saying that all week here. What are you going to do here?
Okay, he pushed out to a kick shot on the one.
But isn't that too close to the rail to take?
No.
My guess is you'd give it to him.
Actually, it's not too close to the rail. I could hold the cue ball from there, but the thing about it is the 2 and the 9 over on the right side over here was in the way of the one ball.
Right.
There
right.
wasn't really a lot he can do. He can actually hold the cue ball, but what he has to do, he tries, you know, I give it back to him. So what he has to do is he tries to hit it kind of extra hard to make sure the one ball gets away.
Get deep enough behind
and
it.
He couldn't get deep enough. The one actually came out, I think is what's going to happen.
Well, the ideal distance is 3 or 4 inches off the rail for this kind of shot. Okay, we'll see how he executes it here.
Yeah, this was kind of a, you know, kind of a tricky little shot because of the, he hit it kind of hard, and, you know, he kind of got away with it. I didn't have a real good shot, but this was very difficult shot for me.
Yeah, and, you go ahead and shoot at it?
And I shoot at it because, you know, I really didn't have a good safety. I looked at it and I said, well, the safety here is definitely as hard as the shot.
Well, right, and you always take the shot.
Always take the shot. That's always something that you
But how are you going to play this, Johnny? You can't draw it or anything, and if you lag it in, the cue ball might go into the two ball.
I hold it away from the two. I go past the two on this side.
Okay.
And, you know, I'm trying to, if I happen to go into the six, you know, the cue ball is really not going to
Well, I like that shot because it's possible that the 5-9 might block the one anyway if you don't make it, right?
If I overcut the one, it comes back out.
Or even a hair thick.
A hair thick, it's still going to hit the point and come back out.
Oh, that's
I actually hit it good.
You hit it real good.
And missed the six.
Well, isn't this angle a little funny to get on the three here?
It was a little funny, but it wasn't. It actually looks a lot easier than it was because, you know, what I done here is I tried to just stiff the two. I didn't try to go for too much here. You know, instead of drawing it to the side rail and back up under the three, anything, I just tried to hold my angle and just take a little bit of a tough shot on the three in case that's what happens.
Okay, well, you want to go up the table anyway for the four ball.
Yeah, and that just made it to where, you know, I'm going to have to go up table anyway on the four. So, actually, I end up laying better than I thought I could here after this shot. But that was another part where I didn't go for so much. I wanted to make sure at least I, you know, because if I'm having to draw it real bad, that's going to make the shot a little bit harder.
Yeah.
And so I just wanted to make sure that I was pocketing the two. And see, I actually came off.
Oh, yeah.
Came off a little better than I thought I could.
Great, actually. You know? As I viewed it on the screen, I didn't think you had that good of an angle. And notice, ladies and gentlemen, how easily he hit that. That made his draw take more quickly.
Exactly. And made the shot easier, the easier I hit it.
Sure.
And now the angle was perfect to get back down for the four.
Now, but the five to the six is
five
no,
to
no
six
gimme.
Lay,
how do you decide to do that?
It lay difficult. What I done here, here's was my thinking about this time. I looked at the four, and I said, okay, the four is an easy shot, and I'm going toward the five. So what I made sure I done here, I said, hit this maybe just a hair harder to get closer to the five, to where the five's going to be an easier shot no matter what I decide to do. So that's what I done here. I wanted to get as far down as I could for the five, because if I hit it too easy and stay up table, then whatever option I decide, if I lay tough on it, then it's going to be a little bit harder to hold.
Yeah, but
the
as
five.
I see this, this is about the angle you'd normally want, except for the nine ball.
The nine ball was in my way. I could have maybe came to the short side of the six up table and just missed the nine, but there was a chance of scratching, for one thing, and there was a shot of kissing the edge of the nine and scratching, or hitting the nine. So what I decided to do here is just take my shot and go back across table and shoot the six back up in the other corner. And I actually laid good on it. It kind of got on the rail on me, which made it a little bit more difficult. But
this is okay, because you can just go forward a couple of inches or even stop it if you want.
Exactly.
But you probably go forward would be my guess.
It was, I just kind of firmed it a little bit and, made sure I kept my straightness on the ball and stayed down. I wanted to make sure. I remember thinking, just keep your head down on this.
Yeah, that's perfect.
Kept my head down
a few
on
inches.
It.
Nice shot.
And now here, the angle on the seven laid pretty good, just to make the seven.
I think it's worth mentioning too, because we have a lot of aspiring players that watch these tapes, that you go to a lot of trouble not to get straight in on the seven, because that makes it tough.
That's exactly right. I want to just, you always, the thing about nine ball is, people try, I see a lot of players, they try to hold angles, they try to get closer to balls, to make the shot, easier. The thing about it is, all nine ball is angles. If you stay on the right side of the ball, the game's so much easier.
Oh, no.
The natural angle is just so much easier than, that's why a lot of people just, I see them trying to go for balls as close to the side. Well, I'm going to go up table, the ball's in the side. It'd be easy to make the ball on the side, but if you fall on a bad angle, your position's messed up.
Especially on tough equipment.
On tough equipment.
Whereas, all right, it's 6-4, and you're fighting your way back.
Here's where I thought, well, okay, I've got a lot better chance now.
Now let me ask you a question, Johnny. You're kind of torn as to what to do on the break shot, because you did jump the table twice, but last time you took some of the velocity off and you didn't make anything.
Okay, what I was thinking here, I remember I said, okay, maybe I found the spot, to where. Okay, I'm not going to scratch anymore now, so just go ahead and make sure you hit the balls good and more firm here.
A little
that
firmer
was my,
this time. That's
that
what
was
I suspected
thing.
You would do.
Okay,
yeah, right,
see,
you
I
did,
went ahead
yeah.
and hit the balls a little more firmer, and see, I actually got a little lucky kiss and made the ball, and I got a shot on the one ball here. And now, here's a shot that always gives me problems. My speed on this shot's always bad.
Where's the two ball here?
Okay, the two's gone. The three's on the side rail
okay.
over here. The two ball's the one that went in. And cutting this, now I had to use inside English here, but a lot of times I do exactly what I've done. See, I hit the one fat, okay, and the bottom English took, and it left me where, I come up too short.
All right, what do you decide to do with this?
Okay, what I decided to do here was bank a little bit at the three, but not really go for it. But then hit it to the side rail and the double bank back across to the back rail. That was my my shot here. Just kind of draw it kind of past the nine. Okay. And I end up getting, away with it to a certain point. But the main thing was to hold the three ball on the back rail. That was the main thing. And I see a lot of players, they shoot that shot and they try to make sure the cue ball comes to the bottom rail. You don't have to do that. A lot of times just control the object ball. If you make sure it's on the bottom rail, that cuts off a lot of opportunities.
Oh, sure.
There's a lot of options are just not there.
Well, I don't like, I'd go to the right side of the nine here.
Okay, here's where I like the shots kicking to the back rail. That's what I would do. And see, he got away with it, but he scratched. I mean, he actually had a pretty good safety, but he scratched. Now, I shoot that shot a lot. It's actually a pretty safe shot. because if it goes in, fine. If the only thing it would hurt you is if it hangs up, you know, it hangs up in the corner. But a lot of times that ball hits that side rail and comes back across.
He did make a good shot, yeah.
Yeah, he just
happened to scratch.
Happened to scratch, which was, you know, unfortunate. There's really nothing you can do there. Okay, and I was kind of, this is where I got it. I got where I didn't want to get.
This is awkward.
Yeah, I wanted to come up far enough where I can hit the side rail and come over.
So what do you do, just lag this in?
Yeah, I just put a little bit of inside on it and just held my angle. I had to just take my shot, which it made this one a little more difficult because now I got to use more inside English to go in between the 7 and 9.
And or so you could go two rails here if you preferred to.
Yeah, but then it makes the 6 kind of a sharp angle, and I didn't really want that. So I just wanted to lag it in with a little inside.
That's a good shot.
And in between the 7. And I laid kind of funny on this one.
Yeah, I see that.
Because I got straight on the 6. I wanted angle either way here.
You just have to draw it back and try to get close to the 7 here, right?
Yep, that's exactly what I tried to do. And laid pretty good on it here, you know, from what I had. But, you know, I had a shot to where, you know, I was going to go around 3 rails here. I actually hit it kind of weak, hit it kind of soft. But I remember what I was thinking is a lot of times I come up on them balls and I pop my head up a little bit extra.
Don't we all? Don't we all?
On this shot here. So I wanted to make sure I stayed down and kind of forgot to hit it and came up short on it. But it was, it wasn't that difficult of a shot, you know, I had to spin it to the bottom rail, the right rail over there, and just kind of toward the 9. I thought I might have missed this ball when I hit it. I remember this, but the spin actually took by the time it got to the ball, it looked like, and kind of spun it over.
Well, this isn't the easiest of shots here. The 9 interferes with the bridging of the shot a little bit, and sometimes
you can
twist the cue or something.
Mm-hmm. But here's another one where the shot's not hard if you just keep your head down and keep. A lot of people think, well, I just keep my head down. That's not all in staying still. That's not all in the fundamentals. You have to keep your head down and you have to keep your stroke going forward.
Well, I'm glad you got up from this shot, and I think it's worth talking about a minute. It's just like golf. If you're a little bit uncomfortable, you'd be well advised to get up from it. Because this is not, you could make a mistake here awfully easy.
Oh, yeah. And the thing about it is, you know, really all I've got to do is just make the ball.
Right.
But sometimes that's one of the hardest things you can imagine is to have to make the ball. So I just kept my head down and just, kept my stroke going forward. And, you know, it makes the shot a lot easier, you know, than it has to be.
Now, those white marks, Johnny, is that from Morro's powder usage?
Probably his and mine. I use powder too when it gets kind of wet. I use a good bit of powder on my fingers, and because the worst thing in the world is uncomfortable with your being uncomfortable with your stroke.
Right. All right. It's 6-5.
It's 6-5 now, and you know, so now I know I'm back in the match now. And you see, I'm just checking every rack. Just it's tough enough to make a ball on the break, so you have to. I have to try to make sure,
One thing I noticed in the matches I played here this week is that if you put the one ball where it settles, it's a good half an inch above the spot.
It is. The balls are racking very high.
Which is probably why not many corner balls are being made.
That's right. You're not seeing a lot of corner balls made. Now, about this time, I know that I'm back in the match now. But I remember what people do a lot when they come back in the matches, like to get it close. Sometimes they think, oh, well, you know, here I got a chance, but they make a mistake. They make a kind of a mental error, and they don't, you know what I'm saying? They don't, stay in control of their self.
Sure.
Whereas what you have to do is you have to go on and say, okay, just keep my game plan going, just like we were talking before.
Well, you're doing that very nicely. And I noticed that this game and the previous one, when you broke them, you pretty much stopped the cue ball in the middle of the table. You just got kissed out of the middle of the table. But here you've made 2 balls and controlled the cue ball very nicely, and you've gotten rid of that jumping off the table. And
yeah, I've, about almost sobbed at about this point during the match. And
but this is a hard shot. Is the two ball up there?
The two ball's down on the bottom rail, and the one ball doesn't pass the six. But the way I was trying to make the one here is I was wanting to make sure I hit it all the way up table and catch the side of the rail, and the one may go in. But what I was doing, I was holding the cue ball behind the 3 and 8 down there to where if the one stops anywhere down there, he's going to be snookered. Okay, now I didn't hit it that bad, but you can see I hit too far up the rail. But see, I left him safe and left him where he had no shot on the one. He had to kick.
Well, as that actually occurred, Johnny, you're a little fortunate the six didn't go.
Exactly right. The one could have stopped and got.
Now, he tried to make the six off the backside of the one. He just caught the one a little thick.
Yeah, he tried to make the six and left me no shot. I had no shot to get to the two. I actually had no pocket.
But so, you've got several ways to play this safe.
Yeah, there's two or three different ways. So I kind of played the simple way. I shot it up and just followed the cue ball forward behind the 3-8.
Yeah, cutting the one just slightly to your left, making sure you don't hit the 9.
It kind of laid pretty good to where it wasn't that difficult. Actually, the cue ball went a little bit further than I wanted because... He can actually get to the bottom rail, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, he can twist between
the 3 and 8.
He can
actually get to the bottom rail, yeah, and it made it to where he can.
Yeah, but even if he can, it looks to me like he can't catch the one thick enough to do much good. I mean, he'd want to go to the end rail and come back and hit the one thick.
That's exactly right. I can't remember exactly what he does here, but.
Well, this is a tough shot.
And about this time, he knows that he wants to make sure if he can win one of these next couple games here, he still has a great chance to win the match. And now I'm thinking the same thing. If I can win one of the next couple games, now I'm still really in the match. And so he actually can get to the bottom rail.
Might be a good shot to try to hit the one thinly, similar to that other shot that he scratched on.
Right.
You know, bring the cue ball all the way back down the table, maybe the one ball over to the side rail and back in the middle of the table up there in the box area.
Right.
Yeah, okay, see, I knew it laid where he couldn't get deep enough behind it.
I think he kind of hit that a little bit too hard. I think if he had hit it easier, he could have massaged a little more. The one ball could have just came and left me a long shot. But this shot here was a kind of a tricky shot, but it was a pretty safe one too. Just shoot it in and then draw kind of up under the 7. And I just wanted to make sure I didn't get too straight on the 2. Okay, so it actually laid good for me. I actually got a little fortunate.
You got below it.
Got it stayed on the bottom rail. And
well, this 3 is a little touchy too, because you either have to play the combination or play it in a side pocket, right?
Yeah, and actually, I made a bad shot here. I shoot the 2, and I came up. What I was trying to do was, matter of fact, I can't even remember what I was trying to do. Oh, I was just trying to go forward and shoot the 3 over by the 5 because it did pass. And see, I came too far.
Yeah, this doesn't go by the 8.
Yeah, it doesn't go by the 8, and I came too far to shoot it in the corner down by the 5. So,
you want to put him on the 8 ball here?
I cut the 3 to the left side real thin, and I'll leave the cue ball behind the 5-9.
All right, now that's a good shot for any aspiring players because what he's going to do is let the 8 block the forward progress of the 3 ball.
Right, and stops
really
it right there.
He's really got about a 10-inch area to put the cue
ball
in.
Oh, yeah, it's pretty natural. The shot kind of laid a lot easier than just trying to lag it behind the 8, the cue ball.
Just like that. See how the 8 stops the 3 from going anywhere?
The only thing I wanted to make sure that the 3 ball didn't get dead on the 8, so I made sure I didn't cut it too much.
Well, you didn't. You made a nice shot. And this is an awkward kick here.
Yeah, he didn't have a lot. He just could just hit it and hope for the best.
And well, he might get the best.
He got the best. Oh, yeah, I remember this game. This was a very weird game because he snookered me there, and I didn't have a whole lot here.
Well, if you go to the side rail, if you hit the high side of the 3, you can scratch.
yeah, what I try to do here. I try to, in case I got lucky here, to hit the side of the three and make the six, but I wanted to make sure I hit that side of three and separate the balls, like you were saying before, and I got fortunate and left him where he could only hit a piece of the three. But I wanted, that was another thing, I wanted to make sure I separated the balls and hitting that side of it. If I went to the other side, the eight had me blocked where I couldn't get the cue ball by it.
Well, you made a good shot.
Now here, what he's trying to do here is cut the three in the side, plus in case he hits the edge of the five good, the cue ball can make the six or make the five in the corner.
We could also scratch off the...
He could also scratch.
Off the five or the nine.
But he's trying to... okay, he had to hit the three fat. Okay, and nothing went and left.
Boy, I see what you mean. This is a very,
this is a very
strange
weird
game.
Very weird game to win.
Neither one of you
get
anything
land
to shoot at.
And this this is a very weird shot here.
Well, it looks to me like you might be able to cut that to your right, a little low left English, cue ball over to the side rail and maybe back over behind the 8-9.
Actually, I'm offensive here.
Is that right?
Yeah, I had to shoot really away from the three to try to cut it in.
Oh, you can cut this.
I could cut it, but what I was trying to do here, I knew I was going into the nine, and I said, well, there's a shot to bank the nine in.
Maybe make the six
or
make the cue ball off
or
the
make the six ball off the nine, or even make the nine in the other side.
Okay, three-way shot.
So a kind of a, you know, and a three ball, I'm trying to make it too. So
you're using a little low right English?
Low right English here. See, actually, I make the three, make the six. Okay.
Boy, and, close to scratching.
Close to scratching. And the five's laying down there, kind of a real long way away. And, but I make a good shot here. Here's a shot where I didn't try to do nothing with the cue ball. I just put a little bit of high left English on it, made it go into the side of the seven. But what I wanted to make sure, in case I wanted to just hit a piece of the seven. So in case I happen to miss the seven, cue ball's going out to where I can cut the seven into the right corner
right
where the five goes.
You just hit it at a nice medium speed.
And I just hit it kind of just nice medium speed. If I happen to not get a shot, and I just play safe behind it. But I want to just make sure that, you know.
Yeah, that's very nice.
You know, in case I got a shot, I was going to, you know, a lot of guys would have maybe tried to jack up and draw it or do something. I just didn't want to take that chance at that time.
Now what do you do here, go three rails?
I just cut the seven in, just lag it in and take kind of a long cut shot on the eight. The three rail shot laid where it was going up kind of high, and I couldn't really keep it going toward the eight off the last rail.
It was going up kind of high,
and I didn't want to land on the 50-yard line. I knew it was definitely a good chance I could land there. So I just end up just cutting the seven in and then just playing the eight in the same pocket.
That's a good shot.
Yeah, it's kind of just one of them type of shots where you're just going to have to just take what you get. You know, game's tough anyway, so you just go ahead and just take what you get.
Okay, it's going to be six games apiece. Now, if you're Morro in this position, you're still in it, you need to maybe have a talk with yourself and settle yourself down. No reason to get all excited. It's hard to keep any great player from beating you a few games in a row once in a while.
True. That's what, you know, he should have done. And about this time. And actually, he does. You know, he done the best with the shots he had. You know, he's going to have some opportunities here and to go ahead and have a chance to beat me. And about this time, I've actually kind of solved my problem I had on the break.
You broke very nicely.
No more jumping.
I made two balls both the last efforts.
Okay, I made a ball there. Got a shot on the one. It was
These balls are laying nicely, no special
this
problems
was,
here.
This was like making the nine ball here. The one ball is actually kind of like the nine ball. If I can actually make this and hold my position, you know, the rest of the rack was kind of easy.
Well, the 3-5 were close to each other.
3-5 were close. If I come way too far down on the three, but it was hard to get down that far where the two's at. You know, so I knew that if
I'm saying, though, if you get on the two ball here, and of course, the six, seven, eight, nine are all at the same end, no big problem there.
The only little tricky part was the six to the seven, because if I fell straight on the six, it laid it tough for the seven. I didn't want to have to go back across the rail. So what I wanted to make sure, I wanted to make sure I got good on the five to do it. So here, I just want to come up short on the three to where I didn't want to come down. I didn't want to come down too far to where I had to go kind of into the five.
Right.
So I want to keep it short on the three here to where I can go to the bottom rail.
Well, you just come straight up. You don't
straight
go to
up.
The rail here.
Yeah, I didn't go to any rails. Just come straight up, and I kept it kind of short on the three to where here I just went to the bottom rail and back out and held my angle on the five to where I'm coming to the side rail and toward the six. And if I fall good, then I can actually keep a good angle on the six. And I spun it kind of, as you can see the ball spun, I spun it away from the five at that point.
Well, that way you can maintain your
that
angle.
That way I maintain my angle real good.
Now, I like to go two rails here. Pass the side pocket and out a ways.
Are you talking about?
You're going to play position for the left-hand side, aren't you?
No, I'm playing position for the corner here.
Oh, okay.
Just drawing
corner,
it. Okay. I had enough. I can hit the five thick enough to where just spin
oh,
it
yeah,
in.
Oh, yeah, sure. That's perfect.
And then I hold my angle for the six. And
I don't know. For some reason, I was thinking you said you were going to play position for the side, but obviously the corner's a better shot there.
The six and then the seven. Here, I kind of thought a little bit extra here because, you know, of the eight getting to the nine.
Well, you know, here's a spot, Johnny, where you could find 10 different great players, and they might play this.
They might play it two or three different ways. And I'll play it different ways. One way, the next time I may shoot.
Right.
But here I just shot it, and I'm coming to the side rail and back out.
Nicely done, and you're going to go ahead 7-6. So actually, from a juncture at which you trailed 6-2, you're now leading by a game.
Yeah, this was a surprise at the time. I was just, when you're down like that, you know, to have a chance with this much left to go in the match, you wouldn't think so. You would think, well, if I got close to him, I'm going to get close to him at 9-8 or 10-9 or something. It's not going to be 7-6 this early.
Well, I'm always scared if I'm playing, you know, the likes of a Johnny Archer because of the great break. I mean, there's a lot of great players who don't have that powerhouse break. But anytime you're playing a guy like you, there's a chance that I might not return to the table.
True. Well, that's one good thing about the break box. It's cut out, you know, a lot of the corner balls going. And guys just getting up and running 5 and 6 racks, making 2 or 3 balls on the break. It's kind of cutting
that's
that
true.
Out.
And but even the guys that have the best break, though, they still have a pretty good advantage.
Oh, they still have an advantage, but not. I don't think they have an advantage as much as with the side break.
Is that
break.
The 2-ball by the 3-ball?
The 2-ball is by the 3 here.
Well, that won't go anywhere.
No, that will not.
So what are you going to do here?
Okay, what I do here, okay, I play kind of a different safety than a lot of guys would play here. What I do here, a lot of guys would try to draw up maybe behind the five, but I see the 4-ball there in the middle of the table, kind of by the side pocket. So I just follow, try to hit the 1-ball to the side rim, back down. The cue ball is on a line to where the 8-ball's kind of, or the 4-ball is kind of a big ball. So I try to just roll off the rail and keep it behind that ball. That's kind of the shot that I play here. See, I kind of kept that line with me. And it came down a little further than I wanted, but I was happy with the results.
That's a good shot.
Yeah, it wasn't a bad shot. It was a different shot. But then again, you know, it was kind of a safe shot, too. It wasn't, you know, I didn't really try to do too much with it. Kept a simple safety in.
A lot of times, the simpler safeties are the most effective.
And here, see, he spun it too much. And he hit the one first. I think he was trying to.
All right, but this is tough here.
Okay, here's I had an angle to go into the balls here.
Yeah, but Johnny, as I look at this, if you
very
hit the
easy
three,
to snooker
you
yourself.
A lot of trouble.
Very right? easy to snooker yourself. So what I tried to do, I hit it at a speed to where I didn't go into it hard. I said, well, I'm just going to hit it at a speed to where I'm gonna hit the two and the two ball. Okay, I'm gonna hit the edge of the three here, but I'm gonna hit the low side of the three.
Right. So you're gonna make sure you at least can hit the two.
Yeah, I want to make sure I hit the low side of the, and I don't hit it too hard, as you can see. I didn't get a real good shot, but it was I still got a shot. But a lot of guys will go into it hard to try to spread the balls or, whatever, and that's when a lot of times you create problems. So.
All right, but now as I look at this. This looks very awkward to roll in. Do you decide to play for the 3-9 combination?
I come across for the 3-9 combination here. The two ball was hard enough, but then again, I looked at it and I said, just shoot the ball in and just come across for the 3-9 combination, take your shot. I shoot combinations pretty good. I'm pretty comfortable shooting combinations, especially on the nine. I kind of like them, but.
especially on the nine.
But I made the two, and see, I came across too far, came too low, actually, is what I done. Actually, straight, more up the rail.
Find when something interferes with your bridge, like the nine ball did there, sometimes you catch it a little fat anyway?
Yeah, I do. And that's what it was. I was bridging right close to the nine.
Right.
And, and I hit it, maybe I hit a little fat or a little extra harder than I wanted. But I shoot it the combination here.
Now this is an incredibly hard shot.
Yeah, this shot here is kind of you just hit. If I wasn't on the rail so much, it would make it a lot easier. But it was the type of shot to where, I'm more or less just shooting for the full part of the nine and cutting the three. But the three is kind of a more of a cut than I wanted. But this is the type of shot to where you just got to make sure you stay down and. It's an offensive shot to where really ain't much of a, I didn't have much of a defensive shot.
No.
I couldn't really do nothing.
You're probably going to sell out if you don't make it.
And I hit it and actually got lucky here. Well, I really didn't get lucky. I left a 3-9. He hit this ball here. Why he hit it like he did here?
Oh, he's going to play the combination, isn't he?
Oh, yeah, definitely shooting at the combination here.
Well, this shot here is a lot easier if you use a little right English on a cue ball. Anyway, Johnny, now he's going to use left English. I think that makes this combination harder to make.
Yeah, and he shot it to where, he did. If he was going to go for it, I think he just should have went straight forward.
Anyway, you can't even see part of the three ball.
Yeah,
here,
I could see a part edge of the three here, and I didn't have a shot.
There's no way you could elevate the cue and hit enough of it to maybe go into the nine ball with the
That's
cue ball
what right? I tried to do. I could do that. This is the type of shot to where I couldn't roll the cue ball to where the cue ball goes toward a nine. So what I tried to do here, I looked at it. I had enough room in case I hit it too full that the cue ball can get by the eight and hit the side rail and still had a chance to make the nine. Or if it goes straight down table, I can make the nine. Really wasn't much of a chance for a scratch, I didn't think, from this shot. And I knew that the three ball was going to come off the side rail and hit the four. So
you could hit that much of it.
Yeah, I could hit that much of it. So the three ball is going to come off the side rail and hit the four, and so it's going to kind of stay down there.
Well, me being a one-pocket player, of course, I didn't watch this match, but there's so many different ways you can go. You could go rail first and go through this nine and scratch. I mean, I've done it thousands of times.
Yeah, you can do that. It was a type of shot where there was no safety there. I couldn't control the cue ball for a safety. And I couldn't control the three.
And there's no good kick here either, really.
No good kick. So what I done, I just elevated the cue, and I knew if I hit the nine down here, at least the cue ball is going to be down toward this corner pocket somewhere. And in case the three stayed out in the middle of the table, it's going to be something difficult. And if I had to hit it good, then I make the nine. But I actually hit this pretty good. I thought I made the nine. And see, the cue ball came off the side. The three ball came off the side rail, hit the four. Now here was a shot to where it was just... It was this was a life or death shot here. I didn't know what to do here. There was no safety.
Well, this is one of those that you alluded to earlier. When you got a tough shot and a tough safety, you always take the shot.
Oh yeah, Always do that. I didn't have a real good. This was actually the best shot I think I've made so far in the tournament, or attempted to make anyway.
What do you decide to do? You're going to play it in the corner, obviously, right?
Actually, I looked at it and it was too thin to cut it in the side. I couldn't play a safety anywhere. I couldn't do anything. So this was the type of shot. It was dead straight in. It was no angle. I couldn't jack up on it because the cue ball was too close to the rubber into the pocket. So what I elected to do here is just slow roll the ball and
kidding.
Try to lag the three in.
That's a gutsy choice.
That's the shot I shot at. It was a shot that I really didn't want to shoot, you know. But after the way it was, I was at least it was a shot. If I made it, I won, you know. So I went for it here. This was actually maybe sometime I might not go for it next time, but. I was a little bit jacked up, but I just tried to keep my head down and just slow roll the ball and keep it straight, and I hit it dead center.
That's a great shot.
It was weird. As the ball was rolling, I had about a foot left on the three ball, and I just turned around and said, wow, because I knew it was in. And it was
well, I think that's one of the hallmarks of a great player like you, Johnny. You realized that was your highest percentage chance to win the game, so you just kind of threw caution to the winds. And actually rolling that, I'm going to guess you could make it at least a third of the time.
Maybe so, yeah. Maybe 3 out of 10 times, something like 30% of the time I might be able to make that shot.
Maybe even slightly more, because every once in a while a shot like that, you might hit it bad enough where it'll kiss off the six. You never
exactly
know.
Exactly right. It was a gutsy shot, but it was a shot that I was very, when I made that shot, I was so, it was one of them where I was just, that pumped me up so much there. I was so, wasn't that I was surprised, but it's the type of shot you don't expect to make.
Well, you're pleasantly surprised.
Pleasantly surprised, exactly. There you go.
Now, the score is 8-6, favor of you now, and I'm beginning to see what you touched on earlier, in that Morro hasn't really had anything to shoot at. He hasn't done anything wrong.
He hadn't really got a good opportunity at the table so far.
No, he's had all kicks and...
Kicks and tough safeties, and everything.
And you're playing very, very well. You made some really nice outs.
That's the whole key to play a nine ball. 11 games, people don't understand, it's short. But then again, if the games are tough or playing tough, they're long games. So you're going to have some opportunities. It could be safeties. It could be...
Well, also, you made a really nice out that one game. Where you cut to three in the corner, and mm-hmm. you came within a quarter of an inch of scratching or so.
True. And then again, here I just broke the balls, and the last ball rolling went in. So.
Sometimes they part like the Red Sea for you too when you're playing well. It looks like even be snookered, and they'll just create.
Oh yeah,
an
everything. And here it is. Here's a shot to where it's. Really wasn't a lot to it. I just wanted to make sure I drew the ball back where I didn't get too much of an angle on the two to get to the three. So I just drew it back probably 3 or 4 inches.
That's a perfect angle.
And kept the angle good there. And a lot of times the way I shoot them shots, I shoot them type shots with not so much draw, more of a forced draw to where I can go ahead and, like you say, firm the ball. Now this shot, I kind of went brain dead on this one.
Is that because, the four ball by the seven?
Yeah, the
ball
four's there? By the seven, and I wanted to make sure I just came off. But as I was shooting, I remember I kind of lost all concept where I was at because I just, I didn't even hit it at all. And I just hit it real easy. And, I just came up probably 5-6 inches shorter than I wanted to.
But this is still a shot that Archer should make.
Yeah, I should make it, but it was as soon as I hit it, you can see I turned my head around. It was one that I kind of thought, I went brain dead on. I forgot what I was doing. But here's another shot to where, just regroup yourself. You're not supposed to have this shot. But, all you got to do is make it. And the six and sevens right there. I kind of hit a little wide. Went a little wider than I expected. But
Now, you got to be careful here. If the 8 doesn't go in the lower left-hand corner.
It goes in both corners.
Oh, does it go in both corners?
The 8 does go in both corners here.
Well, that makes it a lot easier.
It does. It makes the options where whatever side I fall on the 7 is going to be okay. But what I wanted to do here is if I could fall good for the 7 in the side, it would make it so much easier. But the thing about it was the 6 was too straight. It was like real straight.
Bounce the cue ball
and
that
I couldn't
one, right?
get it. I couldn't get it off the rail. So what I decided to do here was just maybe try to cheat the pocket just a little bit and draw it straight back out for the 7 in the corner. This is the shot I decided here. And then I wanted to make sure, I drew it a little bit longer, you know, to make sure that I'm going to have the shot on the 7 is going to be easy to where I didn't want to come up too short on it. But, you know, actually, you know, and then whatever side I get on the 7, then I'll choose whichever way I want to go for the 8. Okay, so I came out pretty good here. Now, here was another shot to where this is one of my favorite shots here. You know, is the lag shots, just to lag them in.
Well, sure, there's no sense trying to bounce this all the way across the table.
You know, I lag them shots in real good. That was one of my favorite shots there. And now here's kind of routine here. Just shoot the 8, come back out, shoot the 9 in the same corner.
Yeah, and Morro hasn't done anything wrong, and now he's trailing 6-9.
He's down 6-9 now, and at one time, you know, I was down 6-2, and I was looking real good at this time. I had the momentum on my side. I was making a lot of tough shots, playing well, I got a couple racks, you know, from the break, and I was happy. But then again, I remember thinking to myself, okay, just make sure you don't do nothing stupid, and you know, let him back in it for no reason, you know, because that happens.
Well, yeah, because
that happens
a
lot.
Here, and he could get right back.
Oh,
in
well,
it.
9-6, you know, he could win a game at 9-7. Now you're only up 2 games now, even though I've won 7 in a row. At that point, you know, you think, well, you won 7 in a row, you should be way up, but I'm not. I was way down at the time. So, you know, this match is not over by no means. So I just wanted to make sure that whatever opportunity I got, I want to just keep going like I've been going how I got there.
And you're breaking the balls well, too. There's been a lot of matches where hardly any balls were pocketed on the break.
Yeah, you know, wasn't really any balls being pocketed on the break, and then a couple times I did make, like I say, the last ball rolling just went in, and I had a couple fairly easy runs, and I took advantage of them. I went ahead and got out on them.
Yeah, but you had 2 or 3 that weren't so easy, and you got out those too.
Yeah, well, you know, I just, you know, I made a lot of tough shots this match. That's one thing I hadn't been doing lately. You know, is making my tough shots. I've always pretty much can get out the easy ones, which about everybody can. But on the tough ones, I've been having problems with my tough shots. But
well, rolling that long hard shot in there.
See, I hit them good there.
Oh, yeah,
I hit
great.
Them balls really good there, and made the 1. And I didn't.
Now this looks like a hard shot to reach for a right-handed player.
Yeah, I couldn't reach. I ended up having to. I don't know if I used a bridge here or not, but I elected to try to play safe here.
Yeah, even if you could reach this, how do you get on the 3 ball?
Yeah, you would. It's very difficult to, because if you run into any balls down there, you're just dead meat. But
well, how do you play the safety here?
Okay, what I tried to do here was just try to bank the 2 ball over by the 3, and just the cue ball in behind the 9 and 7. You know, and if I happen to hit it a little bit short. Maybe he can only hit the right side of the 2. See, I hit it way short, a lot shorter than I wanted. But, you know, at least I knew he was going to have to play safe behind me, no
well,
matter what I
did. This is not an easy safety here, though.
No, I left it close enough to the 3 to where he couldn't do a lot with it. But he tries to cut the 2 real thin and back down. And cue ball got out to where, you know. Now, here's a shot to where I wanted to go for this 2 and cut it in and come straight down, but then I was thinking, I was saying, you know, well, no, just go ahead and try another safety here. At least I knew I wasn't going to leave a run out
Well, it'd be an awfully hard shot to go up and down the table here. You could scratch, you could hit that 8 or 6 and end up.
Yeah, trying. Well, the way things were going at the time, I just didn't want to go for a stupid shot and just give him a free chance to get back at the table. I was wanting to make him earn it. And
now he's going to want to try to get over behind the 9 here.
Yeah, he tries to cut this too thin and go in between the 7 and 9 here, and hits this too hard. The cue ball just squeaks out and leaves me in the pocket for the 2.
Becky, you got an angle where you can just pinch this a little bit and pull it back a few inches, right?
Yeah, I had an angle here where I can just kind of draw it out a little bit for the 3, and then I can do anything from there to get to the 4.
The 4 goes in both pockets.
Both pockets, but I hit it a little bit too easy. Okay, and see, I didn't get it where I can draw it back past the side.
Well, you can hit the other side of the side.
So what I done here, I just shot the 3 in the left corner and just come off the side rail, and I'm hitting the 4 fat enough to where I can hold the cue ball.
Sure.
So I wanted to just make sure I come off the rail just a little bit. And I just try to shoot the 4 in into the pocket here and kind of make the cue ball hit about where the chalk's at there.
Well, sure.
Where the chalk was.
And actually, as these balls lay, if you get on the 5 ball, this rack's over anyway.
Yeah, it should be pretty easy. And the 4 was fat, definitely fat enough to where it kind of just laid pretty good. Just pocket the 4. It's a little longer than I wanted, but, you know, just hold the 4 and just... Then I got the 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
This is even perfect. You can stay slightly below the 6 if you want.
Yeah, I just rolled this in. And yeah, see, I just rolled the 5 in there and just kept the high angle on the 6 where I can go toward the 7.
That's perfect. A lot of players go out beyond the 6, and that's silly. This is ideal here, and you're never going to miss the 5 ball.
Never going to miss the 5, never going to miss the 6. And now you're just coming one rail, and you're going toward the angle of the 7. See, that's the whole key. Whereas if you're just coming off the bottom rail, you're not going toward the angle of the 7, what you want. Now you have to control your speed. But when you have just a natural angle, see, I just drew it back a little bit past the 8, past the angle of the 8. And I wanted to make sure I didn't have to go to the other side rail with the 8. Now here is just a case of just pocketing the ball here.
Well, just like that, and rather quickly, I must add, it's going to be 10 games to 6, and all of that from a 6-2 deficit.
Yeah, at this point, I was very happy with myself, with the way things were going.
Well, you should be, sure. And you can't fault Morro. He really hasn't done anything wrong.
No, he hasn't shot the pocket of ball since it was 6-3.
And that's one thing you have to watch at 9-2, Johnny, isn't it? You never know when a good shot might be your last one.
Exactly.
For the whole match, so you need to take advantage of things.
You never know. You know, that's why, you know, you have to take advantage of every opportunity you get, especially playing the top players. Guys don't understand it. You just have to do that. Because if you don't, you know, you never know, you know, well, like you say, remember the last shot I missed? Yeah, that was the last shot I had.
Yeah, because actually, if you look back at this match, Morro hasn't played badly at all.
No,
maybe a couple of missed hit safeties, but they were tough, touchy, kind of finesse safeties.
Right, that's exactly right.
In other words, he's made no glaring, unforced errors. He just hadn't had much of a choice.
That's exactly right. And here I'm just wanting to make sure I concentrate on hitting a 1. I don't want to do nothing stupid because I know I've got things kind of going my way. Okay, and I hit
you
good,
broke them good.
I broke good. Didn't make anything. But see, as things were, see the 3-6.
Yeah, yeah.
And where he doesn't
now, that's
have a good
shot. Question. I wonder why the balls always know who's behind. I mean, when
always.
You're behind, he needs 5 games to win, and you're on the hill. This is tough to get out here.
Very tough. Here he just draws it out And here, what he's trying to, what he tried to do there was just, you know, the only pocket he had was the two in the corner.
Well, actually, he made a good shot because if he wanted, he could either break them out maybe or come down for the bank.
Okay, here he thought he missed a two, but it went in. And now here, the three ball got real close to the cue ball. Pretty easy shot. You know, you just kind of shoot away, masse it straight into it a little bit.
And he's good at that kind of shot anyway.
He's very good at this shot.
He's a fourth in Maine turnout, or he graduated from there, fourth in Maine in downtown L.A., and they play great billiards there anyway.
Uh-huh.
I've always found this to be a pretty easy shot.
Yeah, well, it's not that hard. And actually,
We're talking like that.
Okay, so he put too much mass.
While we're talking about it, did you ever see one of his exhibitions?
Oh, they're great.
He does great
now,
mass.
Here's
shots.
Here's a tricky part of Maine. Okay, he left the table. Three ball fell in.
Well, the rule is, I can explain the rule.
Okay.
You're allowed as close to 5 seconds as is deemed reasonable. But the player who shot the ball, in this case Morrow, if he walks away from the table, the ball spots up.
The ball spots up. And that's the ruling they made. He tried to protest it. He tried to protest it, but I knew that he wasn't going to get a protest.
Well,
there
had he remained at the table, see, that was within 5 seconds.
Yeah, if he had remained at the table looking at it, he would have actually got it. But when he turned around, he left to go away from
it. Johnny, that's a great point. So for anybody, if you're out playing in these tour events, mm-hmm. if you hit one, sometimes it'll take 4 or 5 seconds. It's still turning.
Yeah, or it's just leaning, or you know, anything's. Yeah, it could be just leaning, like you say, just like a golf ball laying over
exactly.
the edge of the cup.
Exactly. How many times have you seen the putt? They always wait a few seconds when it's right on the lip.
Exactly. You never know if it's going to fall in.
But anyway, you want to give yourself that extra chance. At least stay at the table. You're going to get it if it falls. Then.
That's right. And he, as the time he walked away, I came up and went to the table. And now here I got on the wrong side of the four here for the five.
Well, this is one of these you can't get there from there hardly.
Yeah, I couldn't. And but I looked at my options, and I had a choice where I could come out two rails out and shoot the bank the five in the side, but I had to lay real good on it. But what I decided to do here is just shoot the four in, come out and play the five off the eight. That's the shot I tried to play here.
Oh, it looks like it's laying pretty reasonably for that.
Yeah, it was just another one of them just lag shots, lagged the four in, and there's the five off the eight. Okay, I come off a little bit far, but it actually still, you know, really
well. Well, this isn't too bad because the cue ball is going to go to the rail.
Okay.
After you hit the five, and you'll have position
right.
on the six.
The thing about it is, see, the way I was going into the eight, what I was worried about was the eight ball going down, hitting the seven, and stopping in my way.
Well, that could happen.
Or actually going into the six. See, it comes close right there,
yeah.
but actually gets by the seven. See, if it had hit it any, it would have stopped right in front of the six.
Very astute of you to notice that. A lot of times, guys don't pay any attention to where that ball's going.
Yeah, and you know? I wanted to hit it soft enough to where, you know, I didn't want to hit it too hard to where the eight goes down and does hit the six, or, you know, it could do anything from there. So I wanted to try to, you know, just go into the ball. So here I just spun it, went inside, went straight up.
Good shot.
Kept my angle on the, well, just kept my shot on the seven. And this was actually, you know, pretty easy from here. But here, what I decided, I could have tried to go forward 4 or 5 inches and kept the angle on the eight to come off the side rail, but I just made the shot easier, stopped it.
Well, that's Buddy's way of playing. He says when you have position, don't play it. I mean, really, there's no reason for you to risk anything there when you can just stop.
Stop, and now, you know, this shot ain't much different than going to the side rail.
No.
I'm going back up toward the side where I'm at now. You know, and you know, if I can't make this, I don't deserve to win to start with, so.
Oh, I think you can handle this. Well, this is kind of an interesting story in a nice professional attitude. You made a terrific comeback from a four-game deficit against a talented opponent.
Yeah,
but anyway,
that was a good win for me. I played very solid the whole way through. I kept my composure, which in the past I've you know, done differently a lot of times, and I just kept my composure and played well and really tried to win, and it worked out.
Well, I'm proud of the way you played. That's as good a playing as I've seen on this tough equipment. And anyway, from Accu-Stats and for me as one of your friends, I want to tell you what a pleasure it's been to do this player review with you. And
well,
like to mention, if anybody wants this particular tape or a host of other quality products, you have only to call 1-800-828-0397. And I look forward to watching you in the remainder of the event, too,
well,
Johnny. We wish you luck.
Well, I really appreciate it, and this has been a real pleasure to do it. It's always a lot of fun. You know, you're one of the few that you can sit down and talk to and be comfortable with.
Well, I feel the same way about you.
You make guys comfortable, so that's...
Thank you for the nice sentiments. I really appreciate that.
I wouldn't say it if I didn't mean it. But buy the tape. There's a lot to learn. They got a lot more tapes in there of a lot more players and a lot more great players, so... Everybody have a good time and goodbye.